Started the recording and I hope the audio is good now. Yep. Yesterday, how many of you have completed UiPath RE framework in their projects? Have you tried or you haven't tried? Templates. Just raise the hand. How many of you know RE framework? Okay, only four members seems to be interesting session. Let's go ahead. So there are multiple templates available in UiPath, and here is where you can check. If you go into templates, or if you go into just start, these are the templates, and robotic enterprise framework is what I will select. Okay, and let's go ahead and give it out in GitHub. Team 7, let's go with, I think this should be good. So RE framework is what we have. So the first question that normally I had when I'm training or getting trained for RE framework is, see, I have videos, but where can I find all the questions and all the answers at one place? So the answer is right in your code. If you go into your code, there is something called documentation. In this documentation, you have each and every concept that is related with RE framework. And that is a 35 pages document. So everything from variables, from arguments to activities, whatever we have in RE framework, it's there in this document. So you can use this to learn everything quicker. Okay. So let's see with respect to initialization, get transaction data, process transaction, and end process. Well, for other team members or for other teams, I actually played with a game. So let's see if that game works for you too. Okay, and here we go. And this game will work only for 5 to 10 minutes, not more than that. So let's go with whiteboard. Everyone can have access for whiteboard, I guess. View whiteboard. Okay, no whiteboard. Okay, let's go with note here in the notes.
Okay.
So I'm creating a visual diagram. So understanding and learning a visual diagram is easy for creating your flows and all. For now, let's go with a simple place, simple rectangle. See, the rules of the game will be simple. Rules of the game will be simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so I will add all the team members who are available right now in the team, and I will check. You need to be in unmute. Okay, so let's have the team members. We have init state, we have get transaction, and we have a process end state. Okay, and basic shapes. Okay, now I have values also. So these are my array of values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So let's keep one member each. Abhijit, A, B, H, I. Okay. And we have Anand. Okay. And whom else can we have? Aparna. Then we will have, who is Atruk? ATHHURK. What's your exact name?
It's a Kavita version.
Okay. Kavita. Okay. Just check. We'll start from here. Okay. So who starts the bot? I'll start a bot, or I'll start this game. And this should go with Abhijit. Then once Abhijit completes, he should pass it on to Anand. Anand need to send data to for processing. Okay. And once the data is completed, okay, then Aparna need to send back to get a new transaction item from Anand. Okay. And if there are no transactions, Anand, you need to give it to Kavita. Just check with this process and play this game. Okay, so since we have a game and we have inputs, we also have some rules. So let's see what are those rules. Okay. Rule number one. Even number should not be, even numbers must be multiplied by themselves. Okay. Rule number two, odd numbers must be reduced by one. Rule number three, if the number divisible by 2, then skip the number. So these are the three rules that we have. This goes in ascending order, or you can say first you can check with Number is divisible, then even or odd. Okay. Did it make sense, or are you able to understand the rules, or still you don't have knowledge on these rules? Just tell me that.
It's clear, Vajra.
Is it clear? So we have some rules and we have some game to play. Let's go and let's play.
Vajra, don't you think that second step would always be skipping? Because first is divisible by 2 and then the even numbers.
That's fine.
Okay.
Okay. The rule is a rule, right? So you need not check whether the correction of the rule, but if it is a rule, then you need to see what can be the output. That's it. Okay. And here we will place outputs. Okay. Okay. So I'll start the machine. So when I start the machine, it means that I start a job and robot starts. And here we go. Yep. So Abhijit, you need to start. What exactly will you do to complete this process? Abhijit, Anand, Aparna, Kavita, be ready to unmute or keep it unmuted. Yeah, tell me.
Actually, I will give a number in the starting.
You will give a number in the starting? Your job is to initialize all the inputs. All inputs. Keep applications ready. So that is what your job is, nothing else. Now what will you do?
Will give a number with
okay, you need to initialize this array.
Okay.
Other than that, you need not do anything else. Array initialize input array. So that's what it is used for, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now give it to Anand. Let's see what Anand does. Just call out Anand. Over to you.
Hello, Anand. Over to you.
So Anand, what will you do?
So I have to read the data which Abhijit is passing.
Okay. See, Abhijit already read all the data. Why do you need to read again all the data? Your task is to pick only one item out of that.
Yes. Okay. So I will pick number one.
Why not number 5 or 4?
So I will pick, since it is an array, then I will pick the first number first.
Even though it's not an array, you will pick only the first number or the next available number.
Okay.
Okay. So now which one will you pick?
I can see parentheses also you have given. So it is like
no,
one
that's,
will be the first.
No, this is not a parenthesis. I just mentioned it for to mention it as an array. That's it. You can go okay. For one.
So I will read one.
Mm-hmm.
I will pass. So 0 to Aparna.
Okay. So now here we will see one more thing. Now all the transactions or all the items first are in new state. Every item is in new state. Okay. Now when you pick one item, what the state will be changed to in the orchestrator queue or in anything?
In progress.
Let Anand answer, please.
Yes, in progress.
Okay. So now when you have changed this to in progress, then are you working on that or what?
Yes, I am working on it.
No, you will not work, Anand. You will just pick one item and send it to process. And who is process?
Aparna.
Yeah, just call out Aparna and give it to Aparna.
Zero to Aparna.
Yeah, so here it will skip for zero.
Wait. Why do you have zero in place now?
Yeah, right. I think it will be one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so one, it will minus it and give the output as zero.
Okay, but before doing a minus, why are you not checking with the first one? Go ahead and check in the first one, right?
Yeah. Okay. So it will first check for all the first two conditions as well. Divisible by two. So it is not divisible by two.
Okay.
It will move to the next statement. Even numbers must be multiplied by them, by themselves. So that is also false. And the last one, odd numbers must be reduced by one.
Okay.
So this one is true.
Okay. So this is true. So will it be successful?
Yes, it will be successful for the third statement.
It will be successful for the third statement, and the success item is also successful. You got some output, is it right?
Yes, item is success. Yes.
Okay, so then output is zero, and can we move it to success state?
Yes.
Okay, now what's your next step?
I'll check with Anand if there's any other input.
Wrong. You will not check with Anand if there is any other input. You will just transfer it to Anand.
Yeah.
It's not process requirement to check for output or in next inputs. Okay. Just call out Anand and give it out to Anand.
Over to you, Anand.
Over to Aparna.
Why are you picking up three?
Because two is there, so I have to skip it.
Your job is not to skip any items. Your job is only to pick one item and give it to Aparna.
Over to Aparna. Two.
Yes. So for two, it will first check if the number is divisible by two. So it will there itself skip it, and I think it won't go to the next two conditions.
Okay, so can we say that that is a business rule exception?
Yes, because yes.
Okay, so from new, which state it will move to in get transaction date, in get transaction?
It should move to exception state, as in fail state.
Wrong. So first it will move into in progress state.
Yeah, first in progress. Yes.
That is in get transaction. Then it will check for process state. Okay. In process state, it will raise a BRE.
Yes.
Okay. Then it will move into failed with BRE state. Business rule exception. Got it? Don't miss out your steps. Don't take any additional steps, because robot will not take extra work, right? It will do whatever it's said to do. Okay. Now let's go. So who's the next person?
Over to Aparna.
Wait.
Yes.
Instead of you, let's go with others, please. So Anand, I hope you understood the concept.
Yes.
Okay. So Sindhura and Aparna's job will be changed to Vinith. Yeah. Now, Sindhura, your turn.
Okay. I'm giving the item 3 to Vineet.
Why?
Because the next item is 3. Since that the previous item thrown exception.
Okay. So, Sindhura, tell me one thing. Why are you checking with the previous items and next items? Your job is not that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Your job is to just pick one item that is in new state. And what is the next item in new state?
3.